23 days after being arrested on the 3rd of October from what is now being called the infamous Mumbai cruise drug case, Aryan Khan's finally been released on bail from Arthur Road jail today. And we have with us the man who was in the driving seat of securing bail for Aryan Khan from the Bombay High Court, Senior Advocate and former Attorney General, Mr. Mukul Rohde. So thank you so much for joining us. Before we get into the Aryan Khan case, only because we've spoken about this in length before, I have to ask you, what was the experience like to be physically present in a courtroom again and make arguments before a judge after almost a year and a half from arguing behind the screen?
I think you are the only one who's asked me this question. No other channel has asked. And you have asked this question and so did my wife as to how it felt. And let me tell you, it felt very good. And, wearing proper clothes and proper bands and gowns rather than just sitting at home and wearing a chappal. I mean, I went to court, argued the matter on 3 different days. It felt very good. The first day, there was a lot of ruckus in the court, but the judge was kind enough to ensure that there is COVID protocol. And only those who were concerned with the case were allowed inside the court. And I must say, it felt like a homecoming, if you ask me.
Let's get to the Aryan Khan case now. So we are still awaiting the recent order from the Bombay High Court. So we still don't know exactly on what grounds the bail has been granted. So what, in your opinion, was the argument that you probably made or the loophole in the NCB's case that drove the point home? And
I have thought about it and I have spoken to some other channels too. Mm-hmm. According to me, 2 things were important in this case. One, that there was no recovery effected from the person of Aryan Khan. And 2, that at the most, he was concerned or associated with his friend Arbaaz, who went along with him, from whom there is an alleged recovery of 6 grams on the shoes. So at best, you could stretch it that he was aware that that chap was carrying it, etc. But the second most important thing, apart from the fact that there's no recovery, was that the department clubbed all the drugs and their quantities which were recovered from different people at that time who were completely unknown to Aryan Khan. So if you discover 10 grams with Mr. X, 20 grams with Mr. Y, some LSD with Mr. Z, so they added all this and then tried to make out a case of commercial quantity, which is frowned upon by the law, in the hands of Aryan Khan, which was, you know, stretching it too far, and it was too incredulous a situation. So, plus the fact that these are young people, 22, 23 years of age, I mean, there is no proof of any consumption or peddling or carrying large amounts, etc. So it was certainly a case, at least in Aryan Khan's case, it was a case where even an arrest would not have been made. Because many others, I am told, were released from the cruise terminal itself, who were similarly placed. But in his case, this is how it happened. But
so would you say
these are two important things.